Hey, y'all, you cool cats and kittens.
If you had a guess, which Tiger King star do you think would be headed to Dancing with the Stars? Well, if you guessed Carol Baskin, you would be right. The big cat rescue owner is reportedly in talks to join the 29th season of Dancing with the Stars. It only seems fitting that this is the next stop on her rise to fame. I'm seeing a lot of cat-themed costumes in the future. So, big question, did Carol kill her husband? But before we go into that, let's go ahead and introduce Sabrina all the way in LA.
Sabrina!
She will be joining us to talk about the stories.
Hey, what's up, guys? Thanks for having me. Happy to be here.
Yeah, we're excited to have you on with us.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
So what do you think? Did Carol Baskin kill her husband?
You know, I never actually watched Tiger King, but, you know, what a simpler time in quarantine, honestly. Right? If he did or didn't, it was just such a good, it was a good time in quarantine life.
I think you're one of the only remaining people on planet Earth that hasn't seen Tiger King.
In the midst of the fire, California seeming a glimmer of hope amongst the ashes.
When the wildfire swept through Big Basin Redwood State Park, it was feared that the trees would completely burn down. However, an Associated Press reporter and photographer hiked the Redwood Trail at Big Basin Redwood State Park on Monday and confirmed most of the ancient redwoods, aged anywhere between 800 to 2,000 years old, had withstood the blaze. Laura McClendon, conservation director of the Sempervirens Fund, said the forest in some ways is resetting. That is such good news to hear that.
It is. I love that. I love that. You know, and we'll take, I guess we'll take it to Sabrina.
Yeah, you're in California, so I'm sure you've been seeing that happening.
Yeah, the fires are a little scary, but, you know, I don't underestimate nature. It was here before us. It'll be here after us. Holding strong.
Were you guys getting any of the, like, smoke in LA, any of that?
Yeah, it's been a little fuzzy, especially like the city right above us that I usually go visit sometimes. But yeah, it's air quality is not good. Sensitive. Yeah.
In true 2020 fashion, what would the end of the world be like without an asteroid heading right towards us? That's right, people. The celestial object known as 2018 VP1 is projected to come close to Earth on November 2nd, according to the Center for Near Earth Object Studies at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. But no need to worry. Asteroid 2018 VP1 is very small, approximately 6.5 feet, and poses no threat to the Earth. If it were to enter our planet's atmosphere, it would disintegrate due to its extremely small size, NASA said in a statement.
I don't want to close my eyes.
I don't want to fall asleep
because I miss you, man. And I don't. Okay, sorry, guys.
I'm waiting for Bruce Willis to just walk
through. Yeah, just walk through the door.
And just who else is in there?
Let's go drill on that asteroid, guys. We got to go catapult around the world.
And Ben Affleck, too, right?
Absolutely.
If you were in Armageddon, that movie, who would you play?
Oh, my God. I'd probably have to be Ben Affleck.
There you go.
Yeah,
he thinks he's Ben Affleck.
Yeah, for sure.
I see it. I see the resemblance for sure.
California Supreme Court overturned Scott Peterson's sentence to death in his 2002 conviction for the murder of his wife, Lacey Peterson, and their unborn son.
In an automatic appeal, which was filed in 2012, the court found that the jurors were erroneously dismissed, in part because they expressed general objections to the death penalty on the questionnaire. The court still found that the trial itself was fair and that his conviction will stand. Peterson, now 47, was sentenced to death on December 13, 2004. You remember the Scott Peterson and Lacey Peterson trials, right?
Yeah.
That was like the talk.
Yeah, it was.
For a while.
Was he like guilty of it? Was he not? Like, what do you remember about that trial that stood out the most, I suppose?
It's just kind of a really messed up case, but, you know,
absolutely.
I don't know. Not really, I don't think it's up to me to decide someone's life or not. So that's kind of my take on that.
Absolutely. Well, whatever the outcome of the case, I hope they really get justice for that young little girl. I mean, I looked at it and I just, me being kind of like a father myself, like I look at it, I'm like, oh, like, you know, it's such a tragic story. So I hope justice is actually served in that case. Attention TikTokers, TikTok might continue to live in the United States.
TikTok has filed a federal lawsuit against the Trump administration, arguing that the president's executive order taking aim at the Chinese-owned app is unconstitutional and should be blocked from taking effect. The suit, which has been expected for weeks, claims that President Trump's August 6th executive action declaring a national emergency that would effectively ban the video sharing app in the U.S. was taken without any opportunity for the company to be heard, allegedly violating its due process rights. So, do you have a TikTok, Smiley?
Ma.
I'm going to say he does.
Ma.
Do you have a TikTok, Sabrina?
I don't really use it that much. Fooey,
Sabrina, hey, don't hold out on us.
Yeah.
Do not hold out on us. I know you do. How many dances do you do?
I only ever watch TikToks when they're like reposted to my Instagram.
A lost species has been found. No, it's not the Tyrannosaurus rex. It's the Somali sengi. The Somali sengi is a relative to the aardvark and the elephant, only a lot smaller.
It has a pointy nose and a large, adorable eyes, and it can even fit into the palm of your hand.
So cute. The tiny Somali sengi was last documented by researchers in 1968, which was over 50 years ago. While researchers are still discovering basic facts about the creature, it has been on Earth for eons. So have you guys ever heard of the Somali sengi?
No, but I was telling you guys earlier that like I've seen a video. He's like waving his mouth to the song of like a Phantom of the Opera. But that's as far as I know about it. It's really cute though.
It is really
so cute. I actually saw like a little picture of that thing, and it's just like little bill mouth.
It's kind
of
like this big.
It is so cute.
I know.
Are we expecting those to like be in pet stores? Can we get our own? Or are they still like an endangered species? Like, what's
the
deal?
I don't know.
I would love to have one.
You can get a hedgehog for now.
Yeah.
Thanks for tuning in to today's Daily Ibble Bits show. We really appreciate you coming in, and thank you to Sabrina for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Go follow at Ibble App on Instagram.
Yes.
Thank you.
My name is Sherry.
And it's your boy, Smiley.
Bye. Oh, bye.